Let's do some examples involving special trig limits. So the fact that we're going to use to actually solve these examples is the following limit. The limit as x goes to 0 of sine of x over x equals 1. Okay, so this is a really useful limit to know, and we'll see how it can be used to actually solve a variety of limit problems. So let's start with number 1 that I have written here. I want to know the limit as x goes to 0 of sine of 5x over x. So this doesn't quite match the special trig limit that I know. So in this formula up at the top, for this limit to work, for this formula to work, I need the argument of the sine and the denominator of the fraction to be the same. But here, in my number 1, I have 5x in the top and just an x in the bottom. But what I can do is just do some algebraic manipulation to actually change this problem a little bit so that I can actually use this limit that I want to use. So let me show you how to do this, then we'll actually do several examples using the same process. Okay, so this is what I'm going to do. I can multiply by a 5 on the top and the bottom of the fraction. And by doing this, I'm not actually changing the limit. I'm just rewriting it. Okay, so you see I've multiplied by 5 on the top and the bottom. And now what I'm actually going to do is the 5 on the top, I'm going to pull it out front. So this is going to be 5 times the limit as x goes to 0 of sine of 5x over 5x. So now I have this in the form I was actually wanting. I have the same quantity inside the sine and in the denominator of the fraction, and that means I can use this limit law. To make it a little more obvious to you why we can use the limit law in this situation, the limit rule in this situation, let me make a little substitution. So let's let, let's say y equal 5x. So I'm just kind of creating a new variable, and I'm going to assigning y to equal 5x. So let y equal 5x. So then as x goes to 0, which is the limit we're looking at, well, 5x would also go to 0, right, if x is going to 0, and thus y goes to 0. So what I can actually do is I can rewrite this limit using my little substitution. So I could write this as 5 times the limit as y goes to 0 of sine of y over y. And now this limit I know must equal 1. This is the exact form I have written above. Okay, so this equals 5 times 1, or 5. Now, you don't actually have to write out the substitution every time you do this kind of problem. I just did that to show you that if the argument of the sine and the denominator are the same, then this is going to work out nicely. Okay, so that was a pretty simple one. Let's do one that's a little bit more complicated. So here's the problem I want to do next. The limit as x goes to 0 of sine of 5x over sine of 7x. So this problem looks pretty different than this limit, this special limit that we know, because we have a sine in the top and a sine in the bottom, and they have different arguments. But like I did in number 1, I can use a little bit of algebraic manipulation to get this into a form where I can use the special limit. So I need to start out a little bit differently this time. I'm going to start by dividing both the top and the bottom by x. So in other words, sine of 5x over x in the top, and then sine of 7x over x in the bottom. Okay, and now I haven't changed the limit by doing this because I've done the same thing in both the top and the bottom. And I'm not, since the limit is x goes to 0, I don't really care what actually happens at 0. So it's okay that I have that x in the denominator. Okay, so now this looks sort of like what we started with in number 1. It's just that I have this limit, this form in the top and in the bottom, but I'm going to do the same thing that I did before. So in other words, in the top of the fraction, I'm going to multiply and divide by 5. So in other words, I'm going to make this 5 sine 5x over 5x in the numerator. And in the denominator, I'm going to do the same thing with a 7. So 7 sine 7x over 7x. Once again, I haven't changed the limit by doing this. And now I proceed pretty much as I did before. I'm going to pull the 5 sevenths out front like this. So 5 sevenths times the limit as x goes to 0 of sine of 5x over 5x over sine of 7x over 7x. Okay, and that 5x and the 7x are the arguments of the sine. Now we know from number 1, and I'm not going to write it out again this time, but we know that as long as we have, you know, the same thing in the argument of the sine and in the denominator, that if we made a substitution, it would work out, and the special trig limit would apply. So we could do a substitution in this case, and the same thing would happen. Basically, this piece is going to go to 1. The limit of that piece is 1, and the limit of this denominator is 1 as well. So we end up with 5 sevenths times 1, which equals 5 sevenths. And 5 sevenths, then, is my final answer. So I'm going to do one more problem for you that's even a little bit more complicated. So number 3 is going to be the limit as x goes to 2 of sine of x minus 2 over x squared minus 4. Okay, this one looks pretty scary. First of all, I've got this x squared minus 4 in the denominator and an x minus 2 in the argument of the sine. But another thing that's really different about this problem is that x is going to 2 instead of 0. So how in the world am I going to apply that special trig limit in this case? Well, it looks a little scary, but actually we're going to be able to use the same bag of tricks that we've used in number 1 and number 2. There's just going to be a little bit of an extra step in the beginning. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start by factoring the denominator, just to see a little better what we're dealing with here. So sine of x minus 2 on top, and then this is a difference of squares in the denominator, so I can write it as x plus 2 times x minus 2. Well, this looks a little bit more promising because I do have a sine of x minus 2 in the numerator, and I have a factor of x minus 2 in the denominator. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to separate this limit so we can just deal with one piece at a time. So this is the limit as x goes to 2 of 1 over x plus 2. And remember, I can separate products. That was something we learned back when we did limit laws. And this is the limit as x goes to 2 of sine of x minus 2 over x minus 2. So let's look at this second limit here, because this is the one that looks like we would be able to use this special trig limit on it. The thing that kind of throws us off, though, is the fact that x is going to 2. But if you think about it, x is going to 2, but I've got x minus 2 as my factors here that I'm working with. So I can actually make a little substitution like I did back in number 1. So I'm going to let y equal x minus 2. So if I let y equal x minus 2, then as x x goes to 2, y goes to 0, right? Because I've got 2 minus 2, so that's going to 0. All right, so let's work this out. So let me just go ahead and do this first limit here, because this one's pretty simple. As x goes to 2, 1 over x plus 2 goes to 1/4. That's just nice and continuous. I can just plug the 2 right in. Okay, now let's rewrite this second limit using my substitution. So if I rewrite this with y's, I've got the limit as y goes to 0 of sine of y over y, which is exactly my special trig limit. So that just equals 1. So this is 1/4 times 1, which equals 1/4. So as you can see, with a little bit of algebraic manipulation, you can use this special trig limit in a variety of situations.